Yo, yo, chat, what's going on? Rob? Here, this is what you look like, Rob. I think this is you. We'll start briefing here in about 30 seconds. I see you, Rob. I see you. Do one last quick walk around the airplane, and we'll brief up and get out of here. Airplane's been fueled and loaded already. One last walk around, make sure all the chocks and all the covers and things like that are removed. Alright, let's brief this. So today is Friday, which means it's the FNO on VATSIM. It's the Pot O' Gold FNO featuring Seattle, Portland, Charlie, Yankee, Victor Romeo, and Anchorage. We're going to be flying out of Nome, Alaska, and flying in Anchorage with the Pilot Club. Not too many of us today. I think it's about 6 or 7 of us flying today. And a few of us are going to join up mid-route later. They're flying smaller airplanes, so they're not going to do the whole Nome to Anchorage. They're departing somewhere midway. So here's our route. We're going to be direct OME, then the J111 to Winter, and the Croto 4 into Anchorage. Here's what it looks like in Sky Vector. I always forget how big Alaska actually is compared to the rest of the United States. Pretty crazy. Anyways, weather doesn't look too bad. The wind is ripping though here in Nome. Winds right now out of the north, 360/27, gusting 33. 10 statute miles clear, minus 15, minus 21, altimeter 300. We're going to be using runway 3 here at Nome. We'll see how the takeoff goes. In my past experience with the CJ4 and FS2020, it doesn't have enough yaw authority on hard crosswinds, so we'll see if I can keep it on the runway on takeoff. Usually I'm like mashing the rudder all the way into the wind and having to use tow brake just to keep it on the runway, so we'll see. Negative, Rob, not on frequency yet. So we'll depart runway 3 and we'll join the J111 to Winter. I think Alaska Center, the Anchorage Center, they just signed online not too long ago, so we'll be calling them to pick up clearance. Yeah, Anchorage Center. And then we should have ATC the entire way, being that it is an FNO. Anchorage should be fully staffed by the time we get there. So let's go check the weather over there in Anchorage. Wind 060 at 7, much calmer over there. 10 statue miles broken at 9001 minus 6, altimeter 2930. Sorry, my dogs are barking. I don't want you guys to get distracted. Broken 9001 minus 6, altimeter 2930. But not too bad. There are some showers and rain moving through the area. And it might worsen by the time we get there. It's going to take us about an hour and 20 minutes, hour and 25 in the citation. We'll see if we can beat that stuff into Anchorage. Other than that, I don't know if there's much else to brief. Anchorage is a Class Charlie, and Gnome is a Surface Echo, Class Echo Airspace. So no control tower here, but we do need to call Anchorage to pick up our clearance. You can hear that wind ripping outside the airplane. Hey, there's Rob. Alright, let's get this baby fired up. Parking brake is set. Gear levers down. Batteries coming on. Jennies are on. Emergency lights arm. Standby flight display instruments on. And avionics to dispatch. Lock in our position in the FMS. Clear out these master cautions. And let's start the right side first. Beacon logo. Start number 2. We're clear out right. And 2. Ignition. Yeah, I'm always slow setting up, Rob. I don't start anything until after the briefing, usually. ITT and 1. So you're flying the... Are you getting the hang of the 737, Rob? I love that airplane, man. Alright, looks like a good start on the right side. Climate control can come on. And, let's pick up our clearance. We're gonna go to Anchorage Center. They're still not showing up on VPilot yet. Alright, so I'll tell you what, let's just plug in our route first then. We'll wait a few minutes. He's still logging on. So we'll go to our index page. I'll load it straight off of SimBrief. Route menu, flight plan recall. $133.6 for Anchorage. You need to pick up your IFR clearance, Rob. You can either do it on the ground, or you can call him in the air. If conditions are VFR and you're able to depart VFR, you can always depart VFR and then call him in route. I usually call them on the ground just so I'm not messing around too much in the air, but it's up to you. All right, let's execute that. Making sure everything matches up, and then we're going to go to our departure arrival page. We're going to be taking off runway 3, and there's no departure free. Is it? I think there is a couple of departure procedures out of Gnome, but we're not going to be on one today. We're just going direct to Gnome, and then the J11 to Winner. Winner? Let's see. No, there isn't. No, there isn't any departures at Gnome. Okay, so runway 3, We'll go back to our departure arrival index page, and we're going to put in our arrival into Anchorage, which is going to be the Crota 4 winter transition, and we'll leave our runway open, execute that, go back over to our legs page, and just make sure everything looks good. That's fine for now. We'll verify the rest once we're in the air and we have nothing to do. It's going to take us an hour and 20 minutes to get there, so we're going to have time en route to kind of just go over things and make sure it's all correct. So we've got our route in there. Jump over to our perf page. We've got 5 passengers on board, 300 pounds of cargo. We're going to be cruising flight level 410. Runway 3. We've got 6,164 feet of runway. I'm going to put wet since it's snowy out here. And our wind is 36027. OAT minus 15. And altimeter 3000. No anti-ice for takeoff, flaps 15, and V1's going to be 100, we're rotating at 102, V2 115, and VT 140. He's gone already? No way. I'm showing him on, Rob, on V-Pilot, 133.6. Alright, so we've got our plan in there, departure, arrival, our perf, we're all set to go. ...1200 VFR for now in our squawk, but once we pick up our clearance, Anchorage Center is going to give us a transponder code. Let's try them, 1336. Then afterwards, we'll be going to 122.8. Alright, 133.6. Let's try them. If not, like I said, we could just depart out of here VFR. Alright, so we're operating as Pilot Club 69 today. CJ4 at Nome with the weather. Anchorage Center, good afternoon, Pilot Club 69.
Oh. Club 69, Anchorage, go ahead.
Pilot Club 69 is a CJ4 at Nome Airport with the weather, request IFR to Anchorage.
Pilot Club 69, contact Anchorage on 133.3.
133.3, Pilot Club 69, thank you.
And tell your friends if they're going to contact me, just give him a call instead.
Okay, will do. Alright, you heard that, Rob? 133.3. I just showed Anchorage Center just disappear from V-Pilot as well. Let's see, let me let the rest of the guys know here in the crew chat.
FedEx 3328, Windsor, top of the set.
Say again for 3328?
Windsor, top of the set.
Right now for FedEx 3328.
Roger.
And Alaska 70, we're back.
Roger.
Okay, 33.3. I don't know, was it Anchorage Center approach? Good afternoon, Anchorage Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center, go ahead.
Pilot Club 69, we're a CJ4 at Nome Airport with the weather request IFR clearance to Anchorage.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center, cleared to the Anchorage Airport as filed. Maintain 10,000, departure this frequency, squawk 2207, hold for release.
Pilot Club 69, cleared to the Anchorage Airport as filed, climb maintain 10,000, departure with you, squawk 2207, and we'll hold for release, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, the Eubanks, correct. And advise number one short of the runway this frequency, ready for departure.
Roger, we'll give you a call, Pilot Club 69.
10-40 Center, Fog 1 Kilo Bravo Uniform Inquiry. Please advise, are you responsible for Valdez Airport?
And we already got our route in there. We've got our squawk code in there. We'll go back to 122.8 so
Kilo
we can
Bravo
announce our
uniform
taxi on CTAF. And then once we're holding short, we'll go back to center and make sure that we've got our release. So let's go ahead and start the other side up now. Rob's pushing out. So climate control is coming off. And we're going to start one. We're clear left. And two. Ignition. ITT. Good start on the left side, everything's stable, everything's in the green. Avionics is coming on, climate control back to norm. Do our PAX brief.
May I have your attention, please? We will be taking off shortly.
Alright, we're going up to 10,000.
Portable electronic devices, stow tables. Secure luggage and loose articles.
We're going to be using runway 3, so I'm bugging 030 runway heading.
Extend your headrest and
I went the long way. 030 10,000. And let's run some checklists. Gonna kind of skim over my before start stuff, make sure I didn't miss anything. Parking brake, wheel chocks, cabin doors closed, passenger briefing, belts, start stuff, everything's good. Before taxi, avionics on, climate control norm, pass safety lights are gonna come on once we get moving. Trim, check and set, test our trim, trim up, working trim down. Working and we'll set it somewhere near the bottom of the green here for takeoff. Flaps, we'll test those as well. We'll bring them all the way down. down both sides and back up for the first notch for takeoff. Speed brakes. Both sides. And back down. Flight controls. Aileron left. Aileron right. Elevator up. Elevator down. Rudder left. Rudder right. See, trim, flight control, speed brakes, flaps, hydraulic pressure, anti-ice, takeoff data, we've done, avionics, autopilot, we'll test that.
Autopilot.
Altimeter check and set, altimeter setting was 3000. 3000. 3000 and 3000. Pressurization, ICAS, and aft divider doors. Right before taxi checklist complete. I'll knock out some of my before takeoff stuff as well before we get going. Rudder bias on the brakes.
Known traffic, Pilot Club 3812. We're taxiing to runway 3.
See, rudder bias seats, flaps are set, speed brakes are down, trim set for takeoff, crew briefing.
Short, runway 3. No.
We're taking off runway 3. It's going to be a right turn direct Nome. Nome traffic, we got you loud and clear. TCAS, TARA. And we've got our squawk code in there. GA button. Battery amps. Ice protection, pedostatic. Exterior lights and ICAS check. Alright, so we'll get our belt lights, safety lights on, taxi lights coming on.
May I have your attention, please? At this time,
and we are ready to taxi. Level change at 180 for takeoff, climb out, and heading mode. We're going to go to runway 3, we're going to follow the company 737 in front of us, so we're going to be taking, I guess just the ramp over to Delta. Alright, I'm on the brakes, parking brake released. And we're all clear. Nome traffic, Pilot Club 69, CJ4, taxiing to runway 3, Nome traffic. All clear.
Hey, Tom, you're disrupted. He told us to contact him once we're in the air, correct?
Affirm.
Copy that. Nome traffic, Pilot Club 3812, lighting up runway 3. No.
Rob, hold off on that. He told me to contact him when number 1 for departure, because he's still waiting for my release.
Okay. Nome traffic, Pilot Club 3812, lining up runway 3. Nome.
NJ Mitchum, what's going on, man? I always go the long way. I'm giving up trying to remember which way is the right. Same here, man. I just spin it and spin it all the way around. Alright, where the hell's the taxiway? I can't tell what's taxiway and what's not here. I honestly don't see a taxiway. Apparently I'm on it. There should be Delta in front of me. I guess I'm just going to continue forward. Okay, I can kind of see a line up there. Alright, let's go. Sorry to the citation behind me. Apologies. This doesn't look like a taxiway. We're just going to plow through. According to the chart, though, I am on Delta. Yeah, there's definitely some scenery discrepancies here. Wait, am I on the runway right now? I'm on the runway. Alright, let's do this then. Let's line up.
Nova traffic, pilot call 3812. We're lining up runway 3. Sorry about that.
We'll wait for you. Here, let me circle back and get off the runway.
Here. Stupid, my rudder pedals weren't set right. I couldn't turn.
There's no taxiway Delta in Musfus, so I can't tell what's taxiway and what's not. I ended up rolling on the runway by mistake.
Yeah, I didn't have one either.
Okay. Let's go back to,
Alright, no traffic. Pilot Club 3812. Departing runway.
Anchorage Center, Pilot Club 69 back with you at Nome. We're number one for runway 3. Ready for departure.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center. Roger, just hold for release. Waiting for the radar of the previous departure.
Roger, we'll hold Pilot Club 69. Alright, waiting on a release. Go ahead and get our lights on. And everything else has been done. Just skim through it real quick before takeoff. Ice, rudder bias, seats, flaps, speed brakes, trims, crew briefing, TCAS, radar, GA button, battery amps, ice, pedostatic, lights. We're ready. I'm going to do my best to keep the airplane on the runway during takeoff, like I mentioned earlier in the briefing. The CJ Ford FS-2020 doesn't seem to have enough rudder authority in strong crosswinds in the simulator, so a lot of the times, if there's a crosswind over 15 knots...
Anchorage Center, Pilot Club 3812, passing 3,000...
It's a real struggle to keep the thing on the runway. I'll go full opposite rudder, I even have to mash on the tow brakes, and still can't keep it on, so if this takeoff looks... sloppy, you guys have been warned. It's a simism thing. It's not me, just not sloppy footwork.
Anchorage Center, Pilot Club 3812.
Pilot Club 3812, Anchorage Center, Roger. Verified squawk load Charlie.
Pilot Club 3812, sorry. Mode Charlie.
Like a 3812, anchor trim around your things. Got you passing 5,000. Climate maintained by level 290. And just verify you are on course for Juliet to 111.
Oh, you're on heading 111? Pilot Club 3812?
Like a 3812, negative. Just verify you're able to join Juliet 111 after Nome.
Yeah, he's on it. You're on it, Rob.
Yeah, Ken, I was going direct WONAP, Pilot Club 3812.
Pilot Club 3812, roger, thanks. And that is perfect.
You're on the J111, Rob. Right, you're doing a good job. I'm looking at you on ADS-B.
WONAP, flight level 290, Pilot Club 3812.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center.
Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, you are released for departure. Clearance void if on off by 2350. Time now 2341. Change of astrocut is approved. Talk to you airborne.
We'll talk to you when airborne, Pilot Club 69. Thank you. All right, back to your advisory. Nome traffic, Pilot Club 69, CJ4 taking runway 3 for takeoff. Right turn out to the east. Nome traffic. Alright, we are clear. Nobody on final. Clear right down the runway. Alright, so this is the runway here. Everything's so washed out. Hard to see. Look at that windsock. Pegged from left to right. Power set, two good engines. Crosswind correction with the ailerons. Let's see if I can keep this thing on the runway. Yep, see, I'm having to use toe brakes, which is... I don't think that's true to life. Positive rate, gear up. Flaps up, and climb thrust. Clear out right, let's go direct to Nome. Gauge the autopilot and yaw dam. Are we not on? Where is it taking me? Hold on.
Autopilot.
Back to hand flying. Let me get on course here. Very sloppy. Alright, heading. And level change. Okay, let's try this again. AP. Anchorage Center, Pilot Club 69 back with you out of Nome, climbing through 6,500 for 10.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center, thanks for better contact. Climb and maintain the flight level 410.
Flight level 410, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 83, amend altitude, maintain flight level 240.
Okay, we'll keep it at flight level 240, Pilot Club 83.
All right, up to 41, I see it.
You can cross, it's going to be tagger intersection
up to,
at
240 knots.
10,000.
Okay, tagger, 10,000, Pilot Club 83.
And we've already passed down, we'll just go direct to our
tagger.
Our
so
next
tagger at 10,000, but maintain level 240 for now.
Affirm, and we'll keep it on flight level 240, Tiger 10,000, pilot club 83.
State.
I think I had autopilot engaged before takeoff, and then when I went to engage it, it disengaged, and that's where I got confused there, and then we overshot that turn to Gnome. What's up, Riley? Doing well, man. Alright, we're through 10,000 after takeoff checklists. Gears up. Flaps are up, throttles to climb, yaw damp, autopilot, ice. We'll get ice on for now. If we get above this stuff, then it can come back off. Ice, pass lights, and landing lights. Pressurization and altimeters. After takeoff checklist complete. Riley just wrapped up the VATSIM event in Dublin for St. Patrick's. Was holding for over an hour. Yikes. Yeah, so there's an FNO over here in Alaska featuring a couple of airports, Anchorage and then like Seattle, Portland, and one airport in Canada. I can't remember which one it is. But yeah, instead of departing out of one of the featured airports, we departed out of a smaller airport. We're going to be flying into Anchorage, which is one of the featured airports in the event, so hopefully it's not too,
Anchorage Center,
too bad getting in there.
133.6, good day.
133.6, pilot club 83, good day.
Yeah, I've learned now from the FNOs that I'll never depart out of a featured airport in an FNO ever again, because I hate holding on the ground for an hour. You know, we've done that a couple of times here on stream. I can't stand doing that, so I'll fly into one of the featured airports, but I won't depart out of one. Alright, we're through flight level 180. Altimeters to standard. 3 times. Pressurization checked. Departed from Paris CDG and was holding before I even got over to the Irish Sea. Never seen Dublin so busy. I'm gonna start flying with you, man, so I can get comfortable flying on your side of the pond. Are you still streaming, Riley? Alright, we're crossing through flight level 235 and flight level 410. We're on the J111 to WONAB. We'll be on the J111 all the way to Winner. Yeah, I haven't streamed in a while. Got you, Riley. I've got to watch your videos so I can learn how to fly over there. Learn comms and the phraseology. Going spotting in the morning, nice. Ice back off. We'll just keep an eye on the windshield and the wings. If we see any ice build up, then we'll get it back on. Rob Valkyrie, that was a rough start. My start wasn't too great either, man. I think I took off with autopilot already engaged without knowing. So when I went to engage it shortly after takeoff, nothing happened, and I had to. So I made my right turn to Gnome VOR, ended up going way past it, and then having the bank back left to Gnome, and it was kind of like a rocky takeoff, so it was pretty ugly. Not proud of it. I've got you on TCAS there, Rob. Wait, is that you? What altitude are you at, Rob? This might be the other TPC guy that was behind us, and he's just hauling butt. Riley, I could send you a link to a video I did not long ago of me landing in Dublin if you want, and I'll be doing another one soon. Recording. Yeah, man. Link me in the Discord. Probably should have done on that takeoff is I should have just hand flown till past Gnome since it was such a hard turn. Yeah, I definitely would have been better off hand flying it. That was my bad. Why does Volanta do this? So it shows me as the blue airplane, my active flight, and then it shows me again behind myself. It wasn't too bad of a turn, I guess. I'm hard on myself, though. I did overshoot. We got Rob. TBC 3812. Anchorage getting busy, pretty busy already. All staffed up with ATC. 76 arrivals. And 31 departures. Okay, connect your Volanta to your VATSIM account and it won't show you twice. Thanks, Riley. Let's see. Connections. Okay.
Altitude.
1,000 to go. Leveling off at flight level 410. VATSIM ID. Is that all I need? Just the ID number? Looks like it. SimBrief username? Let me put that in there too. Connections have been updated successfully. Let's see. I'll probably have to restart. Maybe restart Volanta. You are the man, Riley. Doesn't look like it's duplicating me anymore. Sweet. So I see. So it was reading me real time off the simulator and then also reading me off of VATSIM. And I guess there's a time delay between the two. That makes sense.
Last aircraft calling Anchorage Center, that was unreadable by people of the transceiver.
Alright, we're level, flight level 410, we're going to let our airspeed build up to the bottom of the red tape, and then we'll dial back the power. Cruise checklist, throttles, pressurization, and ice. Cruise checklist complete. Make sure we're not picking up any ice. Volanta's very slow tracking VATSIM. Gotcha, Riley. run to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
You're on November 7994 Quebec. Unfortunately, you are broken on your transmissions and unreadable on this frequency. I think you are below the transceivers, unfortunately.
Try testing this head tracking stuff again. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Let's see. It's also a frame rate killer. Let's see. Seems to be working okay today. We'll roll with it. Let's try it. Not Track IR. I do own a Track IR, Riley, an older version. I think it's a Track IR 4 that I've had for many, many years now. And the last two or three times I've tried it, I don't know if mine's broken or what it is, but it just doesn't. I don't know, man. It's completely unstable. I'll turn it on, and just any little head movement will just send the thing going everywhere. I tried playing with the lighting in my room, closing my windows, everything. I can't get it to work like it used to. And it used to work good for me when I was flying FS9. So I don't know what's going on with it. So I do own a Track IR. I'm not using it. I'm using Face Track No IR is the name of the program. I think it was like $5. And it just uses your webcam. So I've got my new webcam up for streaming, so I'm using my old webcam as my face tracking webcam. But I don't know, that I don't like it as much as Track IR, because there's a delay, there's a latency, so it's not as instant or precise as Track IR. I might just buy me another one. Rob says, slow down, dude. You should be faster than me, I think, in the 7-3, no?
Like a 3812, save Mach number.
Oh, hey, there you go. He's going to ask me to slow down. Nope. I have two separate webcams, Riley. I've got one for streaming, and my old one's right next to it for head tracking. And then, of course, I've got the one behind me back here as well. For the control view, so I'm actually working with three different webcams. Nerd. Trying to get back into the head tracking thing because I want to learn helicopters, which I don't fly too bad. I don't know too much about them, but I can control them okay. And I feel like helicopters, you need something like head tracking. Send you the link for it, sure, Riley.
Pilot Club 3812, say Mach number.
Hey, Rob, they're calling you. Mach number.
Mach 76, Pilot Club 3812.
Pilot Club 69, say Mach number.
Mach 765, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 3812, you said you're doing Mach 0.76 as well?
Correct, Pilot Club 3812.
I'll back off a little bit, Rob.
We can bump it up a little bit if you need me. Pilot Club 3812.
Pilot Club 3812. It seems like it should work out for now. I'll get back to you if I see it decreasing.
Keep the 7.6, Rob. I'm gonna back it up off just a hair. I was doing 7.65. I'm gonna bring it down to 7.6. See how we do. Let me get you that link, Riley. Face track, no IR. Oh, Black Diamond, what's going on, man? Good to see you. Good day to you as well, sir. Hope your day's going well, man. I still gotta play with my settings a little bit in this phase track thing too. I'll let you know right now, Riley. Downloads. Yes. Man, I might need to update mine. What version am I on? V202 build 11? I guess I have the latest. Yeah, that'd be it though, Riley. The first link there in the downloads page. It takes some getting used to. Working pretty decently today, though. Yeah. It works pretty well. Like I said, the only thing I don't like about it is there's a little bit of a latency. Like you'll move your head and then the camera so slowly moves. A lot of people have been picking up that Tobii eye tracker. I wonder how well that thing works. Supposedly it tracks your eyeballs. I'd like to see a comparison between, like, the three. I like track IR. I don't like that you have to wear a big goofy thing on the side of your head. But when track IR works, it works well. Like, panning around is instant. Like, you move your head, and the camera moves 1-1 with your head. Face track, no IR. You move your head, and then slowly after, the camera moves. So, if moving your head around a lot, it could get kind of unstable. And then Toby Eye Tracker, I don't know anything about. It's new. I have a couple friends that picked it up recently. I'll have to ask them if they've played around with it yet. But that seems to be the new one. And that one tracks your eyeballs. So I wonder. I don't know if I would want eyeball tracking or if I would want head tracking. Or if there's settings that you could change in the program to pick which one. Streaming too, I'm always looking at different things. I'm looking up at the chat, I'm looking at my stream monitor. I've got Streamlabs over here and my second monitor over here. So if I'm always looking around, kind of looking with my eyes, keeping my head forward, looking with my eyes, I don't want Toby Eye Tracker to pan the view when I'm like doing one of these. It's either that or I have to pan my head and keep my eyes on the screen. Oh, I'm going way too slow now. What am I doing? Let's get back up to Mach 7.6. I backed off the throttle. I forgot to bring the power back in. Music's gonna come off for a couple of minutes. Sometimes I think just using my mouse too is just easier. Panning around and zooming in and out. It's not bouncing all over the place when you're trying to click something or twist one of the knobs. Sometimes finding the click spots can be tricky, and then when you have the head tracking working as well, it makes it even tougher. Is it only 35 now for the track IR? That is pretty good. I don't remember it being that cheap. Dang, I might just have to pick one up then. I'll try my old one more time, but I think something's broken. I still need to invest in one of the clips too. The clip that goes on the side. I think they sell that separately. Unless you can buy them together now. But I've got the old school one that clips onto the hat. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe I just need to buy the head tracking device thingy that goes on your head. Hey, good night, Riley. Off to bed now because I'll be up in a few hours to go to the airport. Yeah, man. Have fun spotting. Take pictures. Have a good one, man. All right, we're about, about 35 minutes out of Anchorage. Let's start briefing this, arrival plate. We're gonna be on the Croto 4. Winner transition, so we're starting off over here at Winner. After Winner, it's the Fitz, then Tyrone. Our first speed and altitude restriction is going to be Croto, at or above 900,000, 250 knots. And then, depending whether we're landing south or landing to the east, it's going to be Tom at or above 5,000, then Card at 3,000, or it's going to be Nicole at 5,000 below 240 knots, then Cullen at 4,000. Let's get a weather update over there in Anchorage. See what the winds are doing, see if we can get an idea of what the traffic flow is going to be like. Winds are out of the east, 070 at 7. 10 statue mile visibility, broken layer at 9,000. Temp 2, dew point minus 6, altimeter 29 or 28. So right down, the wind's going right down the 7, 7 left and 7 right. But we'll likely get one of those. And we are parked at the south end of the airport, so that actually worked better for us if we were given one of the sevens. So let's expect the sevens. After Croto at 9,250 knots, it's going to be right turn to Nicole, 5,240 knots or less, and then Cullen 4,000, then radar vectors to the approach. Landing runway 7 right, 7 left from Croto on track 161 to cross Nicole, 5,000 at or below 240 knots, then 188 to Asley. I didn't see that. Did I miss one? Oh, okay, Asley's there between Nicole and Cullen. 188 to Asley, then on track 254 to Cullen at 4,000. Then track 254, expect radar vectors to final approach course. Okay, for the clip, it's 35. No problem, Riley. That's good to know, too. I'll pick up the clip. I'll try that before buying a whole new unit. If I can save some money. That actually worked better for me. Got thrown off a little bit. That's another thing. If I move pan with the mouse, then the head tracking thing gets thrown off. Let's see if I can recenter. It gets wonky sometimes. Alright, it's back off for now. How are we doing on the speed? 754, let's hold it right there.
Falcon 3812, descend at pilot's discretion, maintain flight level 240.
Pilot's discretion 240, Pilot Club 3812.
A little over halfway there now.
Like up 3812, kind of Gainford Center, 133.6.
133.6, I look up 3812.
We're 26 miles out, or correction, 26 minutes out. Yeah, tack on a couple extra minutes for descent and approach, so. Just under 30, we should be on the ground there at Anchorage.
Falcon 6 to 9, reduce to Mach 0.74 for spacing to Anchorage.
Mach 7.4, Pilot Club 69. As we're going to pull the power back a little bit. And get our speed down to Mach 7.4.
Anchorage Center, 133.6, good day.
133.6, Pilot Club 69, see ya. 33.6.
Center, contact Anchorage on 133.3.
133.3. And Sky Blue 1077, I'm not showing anybody on that frequency.
There is a center. He's there. I have no idea why it's not showing.
Okay, we'll give him a shot.
Anchorage Center, Pilot Club 69, flight level 410.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Center. Descend via the Crota 4 arrival, Anchorage Landing East Altimeter 2928.
2928, and we'll descend via the Croto 4 landing east, Pilot Club 69.
Giant 8144, approach 18.6, good day.
29.28 on the altimeter. Why don't you let me put 2928? It's like skipping numbers. Alright. Or 28, that's right. Alright, we'll just leave it at 29 then. Best we could do. Alright, descend via the Croto 4. Make sure we have our altitude and speed restrictions in here. 9,000 is our first altitude restriction at Croto. So, should be able to use VNAV. We'll engage VNAV shortly before we cross our top of descent here, and then the airplane should start descending down to cross Croto at 9,000. We're missing some waypoints here though. It might be because I have not selected a runway yet. Let's put in ILS. Let's put in the ILS 7 left for now. Let's see if it adds the rest of the waypoints to the arrival procedure. But back to our legs page. There should be a few after Kron. Yeah, there we go. Nicole, Astley, Cullen. That's what we want. Croto. Pull it up here. Croto at 9,000, 250 knots, and then it's going to be Nicole at 5,000. Nicole, 5,000, and then Cullen at 4,000. And then the ILS 7 left, which that might change. We'll see what runway they give us, so we won't brief that just yet. We just wanted to make sure that we have our arrival procedure correct in the FMS. So bottom altitude, 4,000. We'll put that in here. And the airplane's not going to start descending yet. It'll hold the previous altitude that we have set in there. And now we'll go to VNAV mode. And we have it armed up here. So once the airplane gets to the top of descent, with a green dot here on the MFD, the airplane's going to start descending.
November 369 Whiskey Tango.
Affirmative. November 369 Whiskey Tango, flight level 210 inbound Roma.
November 369 Whiskey Tango, Anchor Center, climb and maintain flight level 410.
Climb and maintain 410, Niner Whiskey Tango.
Headed 149 Heavy, flight level 210.
149 heavy increase center climb maintain flight level 290.
Sim is being a little stuttering right now. I don't know if it's that face track thing that I ran. Now it's kind of messed up my FPS. I closed the program, so I don't know if that's it to blame. Could be just lots of traffic in Anchorage loading in, spawning in. We'll see if it gets
smooth. Alaska 110, contact Anchorage on 127.3.
Alright, we're approaching our top of descent.
Alaska 110, contact Anchorage Center on 127.3. 127.3, Alaska 110.
Anchorage Center, United 149 Heavy, are we cleared to resume normal speed?
United 149 Heavy, negative.
Compilation Kid, are you here in the chat?
United 149 Heavy, clear direct ACBOY, resume normal speed.
Resume normal speed, clear direct ACBOY, United 149 Heavy.
Alright, about to cross over top of descent. We should see our V-path start to come in here. Just gonna see some lights. And then the purple mark. And once the purple mark moves to the center, we're gonna dial back the power.
Palico 3812, contact Anchorage approach around 18.6 today.
And the airplane's gonna start to descend.
Pullman 524, Papa Heavy, Anchorage approach around 18.6, connect.
There it is.
Over V-path. Anchorage approach 18.6.
As we cross over our TOD, this is going to center. And then what we're going to want to do is keep that right in the center there. That's going to let us know that we're on the correct descent path. But now, we'll start pulling back the power. And the airplane's going to start descending. So we're now descending via the Croto 4 arrival. Still pulling my power back, trying not to let our speed get through up there, our last speed vector from the previous controller was Mach 7.4, so we don't catch the guy in front of us. So we're doing Mach 7.6, trying to get it slowed down a little bit so that we don't get too close to that aircraft in front of us.
FedEx 5391 Heavy, contact Anchorage approach on 118.6.
18.6, good night, FedEx 5391.
That is pretty out there. Mach 7.4, that looks good. It's bringing in a little bit of power. And maintain that Mach 7.4. Seems pretty good. The descent checklist.
Booker 49.
Pressurization is checked. Ice.
7.3. Good night.
We're going to get on before we get into the clouds here. Altimeter set, cross-checked, and exterior lights.
Walker 489.
Descent check is complete.
Anchors is Delta 1359. I'm flying with him. I'll try and get a hold of him.
Go to 1359. Contact Anchorage 127.3.
27.3 for Delta 1359.
All right, 2028 in the altimeters. That's working now. Three times. It's in there. What happened to our V-path? Why did our top of the descent change?
What's your walk apart tonight? Thank you.
Should come in again. Not sure why it did that. Maybe it's the difference in speed. Alright, there it is again, V-path. Alright, let's get our ice on.
Walker 720 Anchorage.
Go ahead for Walker 720.
Walker 720, maintain Mach point 77.
Mach point 77, Walker 720.
Alaska 96 Anchorage.
Go ahead for Alaska 96.
Maintain Mach point 77.
Maintain 77 Alaska 96.
Corners 1123 heavy, you as well, Mach point 77.
Mach 77, Corners 1123.
Pilot Club 69, contact Anchorage approach on 18.6, good night.
18.6, Pilot Club 69, good night. Alright, 118.6. Man, I don't know why my sim is so stuttery today. 118.6. I think I screwed it up with the face track. No IR.
John 8144 heavy turn right heading 330.
330, John 8144.
Anchorage approach. Good afternoon. Pilot Club 69 descending through flight level 260 via the Proto 4.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage approach, low information. Echo is trying to expect the visual approach, runway 7-right.
We'll pick up Echo and expect the visual 7-right, Pilot Club 69. Alright, 7-right instead of 7-left, so let's go down here. He's going to vector us into the visual, but as a backup, you always want to put in, if you have an RNAV or ILS, you want to back it up with that. Makes things easier.
Low altitude alert, John 8144. And
better,
better
situational awareness. ILS 7 right.
Yes, we're so back we'll put that in there. 1600. It's the airplane.
8144 heavy turn right.
Alright, what is the airplane doing now? It's not supposed to be turning.
Report field inside.
050, join localized report field inside.
So it should be direct to Rhone. I don't know why it's turning. figure that out. Let's go back to our leg page. We're going to Roan right now. Go direct, Roan, execute, and then back into AP. All right, we're back on track now. We might have lost VPath though, so Croto
at... 8145, beach have at 12 o'clock, 5 miles, eastbound 747 at 1600, is sounding report inside.
Let's do level change down to 9 so I can figure this out. Going across Croto at 9. And music's gonna have to come on.
Alaska 748, hello, Anchorage departure, we're gonna currently 3,000 via assist.
Alaska 728, Anchorage departure, radar contact, climb 18, flight level 210.
Climb 18, 210. Last 728. And departure, last 102, 15 for 3.
Alaska 12, Anchorage departure, radar contact, UNXA 230 knots in the climb, climb maintain level 230.
Okay, 230 in the climb, up to flight level 230. Alaska 102.
The 9,000 at Croto is 9,000 at Croto. Let's slow to 250 knots. Right after Croto at 9, it's going to be
Giant
Nicole
8144, happy to field now,
at 5,240 knots.
Field side, Giant 8144.
Giddy, 8144, clear visual approach, runway 7 right, contact tower 118.3.
Clear the visual 7 right, over the tower, Giant 8144.
Alaska 728, clear direct, no wind.
Alaska 748, clear direct, no wind.
Clear this Roan out, and then we'll put in the ILS, actually, you know what, we'll keep it like that for now. Alright, we need to get our performance data approach, outside air temp here, at, Anchorage is gonna be 2. .2928 on the altimeter, and winds 070 at 7. VAP is 109, VREF 102.
Alaska 778, contact Anchorage Center 133.6, good.
Continue slowing to 240
contact
knots.
Contact Center 133.6, good.
Wait, where's my speed bug here? Why is it not doing anything?
102, resume normal speed.
Normal speed, 102.
Okay, we're back on VPath now. Alright, awesome. So let's just maintain speed with our throttle. And the airplane should descend us to cross Nicole at 5,000. And we want to be at 240 knots. Approach checklist. Landing date has been confirmed. Crew briefing, we briefed the arrival, and we're going to be on the visual 7 right, so I'm not going to brief the ILS 7 right. We've got it plugged in there. Redundancy, but no need to brief. We'll do our PAX brief.
0-0, 7,000, 7 right. 0-0 for me.
6-3-3-91, heavy descend via the...
Crew briefing, avionics set, minimums, fuel transfer, exterior lights.
Descend via the arrival, join the 7 right localizer, report to
ICE, we're
going to
keep on passenger briefing, seatbelts, pass lights, and pressurization. Approach checklist complete.
160, 6000, helicopter 3812.
Pullman 524, Papa Heavy, descend and maintain 1600.
Descend and maintain 1600, Pullman 524, Papa Heavy.
Bartolo, Alaska 671 is 2,500.
Alaska 671, 11, incursion Anchorage departure, weather content, come maintain for level 210.
Compilation for level
210. Hey, compilation kid, I was going to show you this, hold on. This approach plate, hold on, let me make sure my speed is dialed in. This Croto 4 arrival into Alaska, or Anchorage, Alaska. So we started off here at Winter, then we went to Fitz, then to Roan, and we're about to cross Croto now at 9,250 knots. After Croto, depending which way you're landing, at Anchorage, either to the south or to the east, you're either going to Tom, or you're going to Nicole.
Pullman 524, Papa, turn right heading 330.
Cool.
Right turn 330, 524, Papa Heavy.
You're landing south at Anchorage, you're going left turn or right turn to Tom, and if you're landing east, you're gonna hang a harder right turn to Nicole. So we're going to Nicole after we cross Croto here in a couple seconds, since we are landing east, runway 7 right. We're gonna cross Nicole at 5,000, below 240 knots, so speed is already dialed in, 240. Okay, now right turn to Nicole. Continuing to send 5,000.
Heavy, reduce speed to 180 knots.
180, 5391 heavy.
Pullman 524, Papa, turn right heading 050, join the local Azure, board field in sight.
Right turn 050, report the field in sight, doing the localizer 524, Papa Heavy.
Pilot Club 3812, maintain 3.
And then it's going to be Cullen at 4,000 after Nicole, so I'm going to bug in 4,000 here, and BNAV will take us down to cross Cullen. Cullen at 4,000.
Alaska 102, contact Anchorage Center 133.6, good.
33.6, yeah. FedEx 5391 heavy, we've got the field in sight when it helps.
FedEx 5391 heavy, thank you. Everyone 920-4-102, I'm last heading 340. Avro 9204, Romeo 2, I'm left heading 340. November 9204, Romeo 2, I'm left heading 340.
Left 340, Avalon, for correction, 2404.
Field is side 5245, baby.
Bowman 524, Papa Heavy, good visual approach for my 7 right at Thule, contact tower 118.3.
118.3, that's going to be our next frequency.
7 right, contact tower at Thule, 524, Papa Heavy.
Hot Club 3812, reduce speed to 180 knots, and maintain 1,600.
180, 1,600, pilot, Club 3812.
Club 3812, traffic clock 9 miles, it's an eastbound A330 at 1,600. Descending report inside.
Traffic inside, pilot.
Screens are, screens are a little bit too bright.
12, Roger, maintain visual separation, one more turn to final.
Turn them down a little bit.
Maintain visual separation, one more time to final, pilot, Club 3812.
Pilot Club 89, just going to maintain 5,000.
89 or 69? Was that for Pilot Club 69?
Pilot Club 69, my apologies, just going to maintain 6,000.
6,000, Pilot Club 69.
Alaska 671, contact Anchorage Center 133.7, got a correction 133.6.
Alright, 6,000, we'll do level change now at 240.
Runway 920, follow Romeo 2, left heading 250.
Left
250,
that one, restaurant, 904, Romeo.
We've got the localizer frequency. Localizer in there for the ILS 7 right, just as a backup. We'll switch our PFD over to nav mode. And there we go. So we've got the ILS in there, even though they are putting us in on the visual. Why is it turning, though?
Autopilot.
FedEx 5391, cleared visual approach, 1-8-7-8, maintain 180 knots until 2-8.
Oh, it's been doing that to me.
Contact tower, 118.3.
180 till 2.
Maybe I'm supposed to wait on that?
Tower at 2 cleared.
All right, back to Nicole. Okay, that could be the issue. Maybe I'm supposed to wait a little bit longer.
Club 3812, turn left heading 3, correction. 100 to the field inside.
Level change.
100, and I do have the field inside. Pilot Club 3812.
Club 3812, clear visual approach, 7 right at Thule, contact tower 118.3.
Cleared visual approach, 7 right at Thule, contact 118.
What is this thing doing? Come on.
Altitude.
1,000
to go, leveling at 6,000.
Alright, just 330 now.
Get our speed back up to 240. Alright, we're back on track here. The field is right here. You can see this guy on final. This is the runway 7, 7 left and 7 right going that way. In a moment here, we're going to go out this way and then loop back around to come in some more traffic here at 12 o'clock on final approach. All right, passing over Nicole now, right turn to Cullen.
Right, 050 is around the 7 right localizer, 20904 Romeo.
Pilot Club 69, the flight present heading is going to maintain 2000.
Present heading down to 2000, Pilot Club 69. All right, so we're going to go into heading mode. Let's bug our heading mode, and we're going down to 2000. God, I always pass it up and down, up and down. Why does it do that to me?
Pilot Club 69, we do speed at 180 knots.
Speed 180, Pilot Club 69. We'll go level change, we'll go power all the way back, and we're going to change... Wait, why is it V-path again? Damn it, I see what's happening. That stays engaged, I don't know why. Okay, so level change. 180. Present heading, and down to 2,000.
Pilot Club 69, is going to maintain 1,600.
1,600, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, expect the vector to the localizer for your descent.
We'll expect that, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, turn left wing 050, join the localizer.
Left turn 050 to join the localizer, Pilot Club 69. Alright, left turn all the way around. 050. I see it. We're coming back. He put us through the localizer. Now he's bringing us back in. Let's bring in our first notch of flaps. Flight Sim. What's up, man? Welcome to the channel. Appreciate the follow, man. We're about to land runway 7 right here at Anchorage to finish off the day. Alright, we're high. You know what? I'm just going to take over now.
Autopilot.
My airplane. And let's bring our landing gear down. Help us slow.
Nearby, up nine, the anchor jet boat 12 o'clock in 10 miles aboard in sight.
Field in sight, Pilot Club 69.
Pilot Club 69, clear visual approach, runway 7 right at Thule, contact out 118.3.
Cleared for the visual 7 right, and we'll contact tower at Thule, Pilot Club 69.
9 Thule, for Romeo traffic, 12 o'clock, 5 miles. It's an eastbound citation at 3,400 descending report in sight.
So Thule is the next waypoint that we've got in here. Once we cross Thule, we're going to contact tower. I've got the field in sight. Runway's right here. We're landing 7 right.
109.04, ma'am.
We're 1 dot high on the glide slope. This is usually how I like to keep it. All right, below 160, flaps full. We're going to slow down to our approach speed of 108. And let's switch over to tower 118.3. And before landing checklist, gears down in 3 green. Flaps 35, speed brakes are down, airspeed, and autopilot and yaw damp is away. Poor landing checklist complete.
Left golf, cross 7 left on Romeo, and ground point 9 for FedEx. 5391 heavy.
Anchorage Tower, Pilot Club 69 over Thule on the visual 7 right.
Pilot Club 69, Anchorage Tower, runway 7 right, clear delay and caution wake turbulence. Previous arrival was a heavy Boeing 777, safe parking.
Nearby Anchorage, clear to land 7 right, Pilot Club 69. We're parking south FBO. Sure. And this wind check?
Wind 070 at 7.
070 at 7, must be much higher at altitude here. We are unable to get over. All right, getting low here on the glide slope, correcting. Hey, good fixins. I'll catch up with you guys here in a moment in the chat. Flight simp, working title CJ4. Yes, sir. It's the same checklist that's on the ICAS flight simp, but it's a paper version because I find it easier than to go down there hitting buttons and stuff. Literally the exact same thing, but it's on a paper. Printed on paper and laminated. All nice. Yeah, I used to use the one on the ICAS, but going down there and spinning the knob and all that stuff, it's just much easier for me to use a paper checklist. All right, we've been cleared to land 7 right. Now it feels like 070 at 7 knots on the wind. Still a little bit low on the glide correcting. Speed should be 108. Speed looks good. And we're going to be exiting off to the right and parking at the one of the FBOs over here at the south ramp. That's where all the GA FBOs are.
Tower from Air Train Edge, post Mike Holman, short runway 25 left, Echo.
We have 390 Golf Mike, Acreage Tower, hold short, runway 7 right.
Hold short, runway 7 right, from Air Train Edge, Golf Mike.
Echo Tower, Echo 537, holding short, runway 33, ready for departure.
Okay, to the 537 Anchorage Tower, runway 33, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, I can have 533. 537.
Zero Golf Mike, while you're at it, reset your transponders, squawk 0241.
Speed brakes.
0241, 4 from Anchorage, Zero Golf Mike.
Pilot Club 69, turn right taxiway Foxtrot, then taxi to the south ramp from Indus Frequency.
Right turn Foxtrot and to the ramp with you, Pilot Club 69.
Take a Cyrus 20 or 920 final 7 right.
Nearby Anchorage, Lakehood Class Delta Airspace.
We're at 204 Romeo Anchorage Tower, runway 7 right, clear to lift, depth departure, runway 33.
Clear lift, 7 right.
Foxtrot's way up there.
We're rolling 33. We'll
keep it rolling.
30 Gulf Lake, cross runway 7 right, set 7 left on Echo.
Could be our first right.
Taxiway Kilo, traffic is on a 6-mile final.
Okay, cross runway 7 right, and we're going to be 210 left on the Kilo for from 839 0 Gulf Lake.
Six-mile final, a guy behind us, so he's way out there. Oh, whoa, did I pass it? Hard to tell what's a taxiway and what's not. I think this is it right here.
Yankee now current at Anchorage, 10607, altimeter 2926.
Okie dokie.
Air Canada 537 left hand turn, contact departure.
We're all the way across the line.
Process.
After landing checklists. Speed brakes are coming down. Flaps coming up. Pedostatic and ice is off, radar on standby, and exterior lights, and we can just continue on into the ramp. We're gonna park over here in front of Millionaire, which I don't think is Millionaire anymore. At least not according to Google. Can't remember the name of the FBO. Something different, though. It is a red building like that.
Runway 33, clear for takeoff. Traffic is the 4-mile final, runway 7-3.
Runway
33,
clear for takeoff for Alaska.
Rob was in front of me the whole time. Good fixings.
0 Gulf Lake, runway 33, modified weight traffic for the 3-mile final, now runway 7-3.
Yeah, we're going to Ross Aviation over here on our left. If you ain't first, you last. Hey, I was catching up to Rob and they made me slow down. I was gonna pass him. All right, parking brake. And shut her down. We'll just turn off climate control, turn off our avionics lights. And we can shut down. Make sure all of our switches are off. And we turn off the rest. Standby flight display, emergency lights, and our battery. Shutdown checklist, parking brake, wheel chocks, emergency lights, standby flight display, avionics, climate control, ice, throttles, engine stop, lights, battery switch, control lock, and covers. We made it, and it was a nice flight, Rob. It was really pretty there at the end, too, on the arrival into the Anchorage, the mountains and the clouds. Let's see. Let me see if I missed any messages before we sign off. I think I'm all caught up. Flight Simp should probably do the same on the checklist. Yeah, man, it helps a ton. Makes things a lot easier. Yeah, I'm all caught up. Good fixings. Dixie. Alright guys, I'm out of here. I know I said tomorrow I was going to fly with the pilot club for their flight into Athens. I don't know if I'm going to make it there tomorrow. It's a little bit earlier of one, and I do have some plans early afternoon. I don't know if I could squeeze it in, I may, but I can't promise anything. So, Saturday is still up in the air. Tomorrow, Sunday, we'll definitely be flying. Sunday we've got... I'll probably stream twice and do a doubleheader, because we've got Virtual USA, we've got the float plane event that I really want to do. I can't miss that. And then Pilot Club's got their Sunday Fun Day event. Let me pull them up real quick. So, Sunday Fun Day, it's the co-op event with Allegiant. We're flying out of Punta Gorda and flying up to, I think it was Albany or Allentown. I think it was Allentown. With Allegiant Air. So we'll be flying the Airbus A320 tomorrow, which I'm not a huge fan of in the sim yet. The fly-by-wire, it's pretty good, but it's not... I don't know. To me, it's not really VATSIM ready, since you can't fly an RNAV approach with it. And it's got no VNAV. But we'll try it. We'll try the A320 tomorrow. We'll be flying the Allegiant Air colors. And then that's at 3 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1900 Zulu. That flight will probably take two hours. 3, 4, 5. And then we've got the Virtual USA event. I don't want to butcher the name. Spring Breakout Your Float Planes. And that's going to be at 7 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. 2300 Zulu. So we'll be flying all day Sunday, but I'm probably going to take tomorrow off. Unless I have time and I'm bored. And I can wake up. So three different factors determining tomorrow. Good fix-in, so I might actually be able to make the VUSA float plane event on Sunday. Good, man. I hope to see you there. I'll have to check with the boss. Alright, I think that's it for me for tonight. If you guys want to stick around for another minute or two, we'll raid somebody else. I'll send you guys over to another Twitch channel. Let me see who's on.
Self-trust.
Hear another airplane coming in here. FedEx back there. Looks like a 777. Who's streaming? Alright, the only channel that I'm following right now that is streaming is the Flying Moose, Mr. Mustafa. So I'll send you guys over to him. Great channel, great guy. Standby one, I'll send you guys over. Have a good one.
See ya!
Flight Sim, nice man, enjoy the stream. Hey, I appreciate it, Flight Sim. Welcome aboard, man. Glad to have you. I'll see you guys on the next one, most likely Sunday.
See you.